Hello kids, today I'm going to tell you another story of Panchatantra, and today's story is titled Mouse Marriage. Once upon a time lived a sage and his wife alongside the banks of river Ganga. The sage and his wife were very happy in their lives, except they didn't have a child. Somehow they were passing their days hoping to have a child. It seems we are never going to be blessed with a child. We must have done wrong deeds.
Have patience, my love. Do not lose faith from the Almighty and stay away from misery. Everything will be all right.
The sage then comforted her with a warm hug. One day, when sage was meditating around the banks of River Ganga, a falcon came flying and carried a dead mouse in his legs. While he was flying over Sage's head, he accidentally dropped the dead mouse in his lap. Sage saw the dead mouse and felt bad. A thought crossed into Sage's mind. He chanted a spell and turned the dead mouse into a newborn girl. Afterwards, on reaching home, he handed over the baby girl to his wife and said,
"Dear, we never had a child, but I know how solely you want to be a mother. Please accept this child as your own daughter."
His wife was full of joy as she got what she wanted, that is, to be a mother. She took the child in her arms and embraced her. Both of them were now content. They began nurturing the child with great love. After many years, the child transformed into a beautiful girl. Now, the sage started searching for an ideal husband for her. However, he didn't want his daughter to marry an ordinary man. He prayed to the sun and the sun appeared before him. Sage asked her daughter,
"My child, do you want to marry the sun?"
"No, father. He's always so scorching. It will be very difficult for me to live with him."
Agreeing with her, the sage called out the god of oceans.
"My dear, he's the god of oceans. Do you want to marry him?"
"No, father, I cannot marry him. He is very dark and cold."
When the god of oceans heard this, he smiled and advised the sage to call the god of wind. The sage again closed his eyes and called out the god of wind. Sage once again asked his daughter,
"My child, will you marry the god of wind?"
"No, father. I cannot marry him because he never stays in one place. He is always on the move."
When the god heard the reason stated by Sage's daughter, he said,
"I believe you should go to the god of mountains. He is the only one who never moves. And he is super strong. Even I can't move him with all my might, no matter how much I try. Your daughter will surely like him."
After saying this, the god vanished. Sage liked his advice. He then went on to meet the god of mountain. However, his daughter didn't like him either.
"Father, I will not marry him. He is so rough. I cannot stand his touch."
The sage got tired of finding the perfect match for his daughter. He asked the god of mountains,
"Dear god, can you suggest me someone whom you think is more powerful than you?"
"The only powerful person than me is a mouse. No one in the world can harm me except a mouse. He penetrates my rocks and digs holes with his sharp teeth."
Hearing this, the sage called out a mouse. A mouse immediately appeared in front of him. When his daughter saw the mouse, she got mesmerized. She said to her father,
"My beloved father, now you don't have to worry about my marriage anymore. I have found my match. This adorable mouse shall be my husband. But for that to happen, you have to turn me into a mouse."
On hearing his daughter's request, he recalled that before she was a girl, she was a mouse. Without any further thought, he turned her into a mouse again. The two mouse then got married and lived a happy life. So kids, from this story, we learn a lesson that we can never change our true identity.
If you enjoyed this video, do like, share and comment. And to be the first person to watch our videos, make sure to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for timely notifications.